triumphant from all our foes. Through the crucible unscathed, we passed victorious. Our trumpets pealing the glorious song. Play it, sing it, all hail Biafra.
Kiwe duanyi nuzo ene nkezi omume. Kiwe wesu garanyi ndianja nine. Ọrịa niile nke pụrụta kwasa mmadụ dị ndụ n'ihi na ọ bụ naanị gị bụ onye na-agwọ ọrịa ka anyị wee na-akpọkụghị gị onwe gị bụ sunile nke ndị agha ka igwe mere anyị ebere ka akwa nke anyị na-ebeku ude nke anyị na-asụ wee bịa n'iru gị ka iwe mee ka Biafra wee guzosi ike ka anyị wee n'ikpete mazụ nye ha sọgụtụte na nsọpụrụ na ịja mma site na ebighị ebi maruo n'ebighị ebi ise mma mma dịrị gị chineke. Mamma dịrị gị Chineke.
Welcome, my amazing viewers. Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you're joining me from any part of the world, I thank you very much for your contributions on this channel. Please, each time you watch my video, go to the comment section and pull down your comments. Make your contribution, say it just the way you feel it. You can criticize if you so desire, but make your criticism constructive so that we can be able to learn from each other. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, in this channel, we talk about the freedom of the people, the freedom of the indigenous people of the contraption called Nigeria. That is what we are talking about. More especially the southern part of Nigeria and the southeast, to be precise. This is where we talk about. This is where our focus is. Remember, we have a supreme leader who is guiding us and leading us, whom God has given us. Chukwukuke Biama have chosen our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, to guide us on what we should do, on how to get away from the evil that is about to come. He has spoken about it in the past. What you have to do for you to be able to hear from our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, directly is to pray along with him in the prayer that he has given us. If you want to hear directly from our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, a lot of things happening, a lot of confusion everywhere. People are not sure of the information they are getting. If you want to hear from our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, pray along with him. You have to pray along with him. Pray earnestly with him. He has given us 150 days prayer. If you have not joined, it is time to join. You have to pray. While you are praying in the prayer of 150 days, pray for the DOS. Pray for the DOS that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have established so that Chukwukuke Abiama will give them more and strong revelation. Pray for everybody that is fighting for freedom of Biafra. Pray for our brother Simon Ekpa. Pray for Simon Ekpa, for God to strengthen him more and more and give him more wisdom, give him more knowledge, give him more strength to continue on the path that he is going. Pray for everybody that is speaking up for the freedom of Biafra, freedom of the indigenous people of the southern part of Nigeria, indigenous people of that country of Nigeria. Pray for them. Pray mostly for our spirit that was in Nnamdi Kanu. Pray for him. He is praying for you 7 times every day. Why won't you pray for him once? Just once a day. Why can't you pray for our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, once a day? That is the only way you can hear from him. If you pray along with him, you will hear from him. You will get revelations. You will be doing exactly what he wants you to do. The only reason why people are falling aside and are confused is because they are not praying. If you pray with our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, pray along with him, you will know what to do at all times. He is with us. He has not left us. Our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, is sitting right beside you, sitting right beside me, waiting for you to connect so that we can be able to move on into Biafra. He is coming out. Nobody can stop him from coming out from that dungeon. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is coming out. He went on a mission, and very, very soon, he's coming out with the flag of Biafra lifted high. That is why you have to do your part wherever you are. Do your part so that we can move on. You can see a lot of lies that they are pushing. A lot of lies that they are pushing. Some of those lies that they are pushing. That is what we have to continue to attack. To debunk all the lies they are pushing out there. They have pushed a lot of lies against our supreme leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, which the whole world have known that are lies. Everybody knows our supreme leader, Mazi Nkanu, that he is not a terrorist. This is a man who has traveled all over the world. He has been celebrated all over the world. How can he possibly be a terrorist? He is not. He's only fighting for his own people. He's only fighting for his own people to make sure that his people get freedom. Self-determination is the right of every human being, even enacted in their own law in that contraption called Nigeria. But of course, they don't obey their own law. That is why they are holding Asorock and the Kano. Even when they have nothing against him, they went and kidnapped him in Kenya and they extradited him to Nigeria. Is he by force to be a Nigerian? He has told you he's not a Nigerian. He is a Biafran and a British citizen. You went and kidnapped a Biafran, a British citizen, who is not a Nigerian, and you think it will be well with you? You think you can get away with it? You will not get away with it because Chukwuka Abiyama is involved. You can't get away with it. The most painful part of it is those people who call themselves Southerners, who are supporting this evil government. Even when they know that the person in Asorock is not the man whom they voted in, yet they are still following him. A Southerner will start up and begin to defend the indefensible, begin to defend the killer, somebody who wants to kill him. Continue to promote somebody who wants to kill him. A Southerner. You will see somebody from the southern part of Nigeria, southeastern part of Nigeria, saying that he doesn't believe in IPOB, he don't trust them. That saying all manner of evil against IPOB. And he says he's fighting for the freedom of Biafra. Somebody will come out and tell you that he is fighting for the freedom of Biafra, yet he doesn't believe in IPOB. There was one interview I watched, one idiot that calls himself a lawyer came out in an interview. He was saying that Mazi NNAMDI KANU was not arrested because of Biafra. That Mazi NNAMDI KANU was arrested because of the crime he committed against Nigeria. Look at what somebody who called himself an educated person, who said he's fighting for Biafra, is saying against the only man who is fighting for Biafra. He said he wasn't arrested for Biafra. That is the kind of people we have who said they are fighting for Biafra in Biafra land. If you see anybody who called himself a freedom fighter and say he doesn't like IPOB, he said he condemns IPOB with all his strength, run away from such people. They are betrayers and they are the people who are enslaving the southern part of Nigeria. If you see anybody from southeastern part of Nigeria mainly who is against IPOB, you can disagree with their opinion. That is all right. You must not agree. You can disagree with their opinion. But for somebody who has so much hatred that he can stand and go and point an IPOB member to be arrested, who can call for the killing of IPOB member on the national television, who can talk against IPOB on the national television, a somebody from the southern part of Nigeria, he is a Fulani Janjaweed, and he is the person that is enslaving the southern part of Nigeria. Any southerner that stands on the national television to speak against IPOB, they are the people who are selling the southern part of Nigeria, and they are the people whom the Fulanis have planted in the south to make sure we're being destroyed. Don't believe them. Do not believe them. Any southerner still standing and speaking against IPOB, talking about one Nigeria, and said he wants freedom, do not believe them. Do not believe, because we know the only organization that is genuinely fighting for freedom in that contract to call Nigeria is IPOB. IPOB. There is no one. No one else. The only organization that is openly and genuinely fighting for the freedom of the indigenous people is IPOB. No one else. There's no other organization. Every other organization, both people carrying fire from one place to the other, you can never achieve anything with that. The only people that has made the plight of the Biafrans to be on the front burner, that made the whole world to be talking about the situation of Nigeria today, is IPOB. If not for IPOB, nobody will know what is happening in Nigeria. You will be there until they will slaughter you and kill you, and nobody will do anything. You see Afghanistan. You see what Afghanistans are facing. The people, the citizens of Afghanistan, you see what they are facing. You have seen the video what they are facing in their own country, and even they in their own religion. They are not Christians, they are Muslims. In their own, you see what they are facing. That is what would have happened to Nigeria without the presence of Asorock and Mazi NNAMDI KANU. Mazi NNAMDI KANU woke everybody up, wake people up, people join the chorus and begin to speak up. Our Urduan brothers rose up and begin to speak. All thanks to IPOB, they brought the problem to the front burner, and the whole world is focused on Nigeria today. And somebody will stand up and speak against IPOB, speak against Asorock and Mazi NNAMDI KANU. That person must be a devil incarnate. It's either you are being consumed by jealousy or you are consumed by wickedness and pride. That is the only thing that will make you to speak against Asorock and Mazi NNAMDI KANU. As a Southerner, this is a man standing for, not just for Southerner, for every indigenous tribe in that country called Nigeria. Mazi NNAMDI KANU is speaking up for every indigenous, even for the Fulanese. while he was arrested the first time, he made case even for Fulani. He paid for lawyers for them to get them released in jail. People who were not even Biafrans. That is the spirit of a freedom fighter. And that is why you cannot bring him down. It doesn't matter how you try. We are focused on our freedom. The DSS can begin to plant all their clique and whatever they want to plant in the midst of the members of IPOB. They cannot succeed. You can give us all kinds of name you want to give us. We are focused. Every organization formed by MAZI NNAMDI KANU are focused on the freedom of Biafra. The few who are focused on listening to gossip, definitely they will get tired and they will join the chorus. They will get tired. We don't have time for gossipers. We don't have time to talk about people who doesn't matter. We are focused on our freedom and the freedom of Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU. The freedom of Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU is the freedom of Biafra. The captivity of MAZI NNAMDI KANU is the captivity of Biafra. If you do not know it now. Once Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU is in jail, every indigenous tribe in Nigeria is in jail. Take it or leave it. It's a hard message, but you have to take it. As long as Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU is in jail, every indigenous tribe in Nigeria is in jail. And once he's released, every indigenous tribe in Nigeria will be free. Every indigenous tribe will be. That is why you have to speak up. It doesn't matter your jealousy. You can be jealous to hell. It doesn't matter your tribe. It doesn't matter your religion. Speak up for what is happening. Speak up for injustice, because injustice to one is injustice to all. If you don't speak up now, it will come to your doorstep. When they were killing these people from Southern Kaduna, you thought it's not going to get to your doorstep. You said it's just about the Southern Kaduna. After all, it's only in Southern Kaduna. It doesn't concern you. You don't talk about it. They killed the people of Benue State. You don't talk about it. After all, it is Benue State. They know what they did. It's up to them. They killed in Enugu State. It doesn't concern you. You don't want to talk about it. They killed in the Southwest. It doesn't concern you. You don't want to talk about it. They have been killing IPOB from the beginning, shooting IPOB, innocent protesters. Nobody talk about it. They kept that silent as if nothing is happening. Until they came and killed their own fellow Nigerians, NSAS protesters, people who claim to be one Nigeria, people who were protecting one Nigeria, raising their flag, singing national anthem, they open fire and kill them. And you think you can make such a country work? People who were captured on video, live, I watch it live, where they were singing national anthem, raised up their flag to protect their so-called one Nigeria. The one Nigeria opened fire on them and killed them. And yet somebody is coming out to tell me that it's going to work. Since they killed the innocent NSAS people, how many people have been arrested or be prosecuted for killing the NSAS? They have not even admitted that anybody died in NSAS up to date. They never admitted. Everybody is going about their business as if nothing is happening. Continue to be silent. Do not speak. Continue to be silent. It will be your turn. Continue to wait until when you get to your grave. Then, from there, you'll be hearing the voice of those who are speaking. But for us Biafrans, for us the Ududuans, for those who care, they are speaking up. We will never be silent. We'll continue to speak. It doesn't matter what they do. It doesn't matter what they say. The assignment that our school leader, Mazin Nagana, have left behind for us, we will continue to follow it. We'll continue to speak on top of our voice. They will never take an inch of Biafra land, just as Mazin Nagana have said. That is the word of Chuku Kabiam. They will never take an inch of Biafra land. They will never. It doesn't matter how they try. You think you're holding Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU, it's all of it. It is only Chuku Kabiam that permitted him to go there. It's Chuku Kabiam. And when the time is right, which is going to happen very, very soon, it's going to surprise everybody. Our Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU is on his way out. And while he's coming out, with the flag of Biafra lifted high, we are going to be complete, intact, and we'll move into Biafra. It doesn't matter what they want to do. It doesn't matter how they push their propaganda. It doesn't matter the lies they are pushing out there. They will never succeed and they will never put us down. We'll continue to rise. More and more every day we'll continue to rise and we'll continue to move ahead. They can't stop us. Let them keep trying. They can never stop us. They can't stop us. Each day you go to the media, go to their conventional media, all they are propagating is lying. Talking about it, how can somebody in his right senses from the southeastern part of Nigeria be talking about Igbo presidency? Talking about Igbo people, when you know that the Igbos are not ready for the presidency, what they want is referendum. Are you leading yourself? You call yourself a politician Are you representing yourself? The people you are representing have sat down to tell you that look at what we want. We want our leader, who is our school leader, MAZI NNAMDI KANU, out of the dungeon. We want him out of the Fulani Janjaweed from their hand. We want him out of the DSS. That is what we want. First of all, then referendum. Nobody is talking about anything election in Nigeria, in Biafra land. We don't want election. Yet, the politicians are pretending. Their media is propagating it. You are going to pay with your life and you pay dearly. The spirit of Biafra have risen high. You think it's going to be by the command of anybody. You say MAZI NNAMDI KANU was preaching his speech. He was pushing this. Now the spirit of Biafra is preaching his message. The spirit of Biafra is in every Biafra is fighting for the struggle. And you will be surprised what is going to happen. Everybody is taking the fight on their own to liberate themselves. It is in our hand this time. It is in our hand. Everybody is up and ready to fight and liberate him or herself. It is no longer time you think you can hold MAZI NNAMDI KANU, you can talk down on DOS, you can stop this person or that person. Every Biafran, from the seat at home, you can see that the Biafran spirit is high, more than ever. The people you have killed in Biafran land have now come out to act. All the life you have wasted in Biafran land, they are now ready to take vengeance. And nobody can appease them. The only thing that can appease them is when our school leader MAZI NNAMDI KANU comes out with the flag of Biafra lifted high. That is the only time they will be at peace. If not, Nigeria will pay dearly for what they have done to the Biafrans. And just as our school leader MAZI NNAMDI KANU have said, Somalia will be a child's play on what is about to happen in that country called Nigeria. Somalia will be a child's play. We are connected to Asorock and MAZI NNAMDI KANU. It doesn't matter what you do. You think you're holding him. He is as free as anything, wherever he is. As we pray along with him, we can hear him. Exactly what he wants us to do is what is going to be going on outside. Even on his silence, even when he silenced, the spirit of Biafra is going to be sending the message to each and every Biafra in Biafra land, and they will be acting exactly the way MAZI NNAMDI KANU wants them to act. That is exactly what is going on. That is why I always advise every Biafran to continue to listen to the message of MAZI NNAMDI KANU. Try to play his messages. Try to play his messages every now and again. Don't say the message is old. When you see the voice, when you see the message of Asorock MAZI NNAMDI KANU, don't say it's an old message. Don't say this is an old message. Play it over and over again. Each time you play the message, it's like reading the Bible. You will get a new revelation. Each time you listen to the message of Asorock MAZI NNAMDI KANU, you will get a new revelation and you will be energized. You will have strength. You will know where to go. You will have your focus. It is because so many people are not listening. That is why they are losing focus. If you are listening to the message of Asorock MAZI NNAMDI KANU, you will never lose focus on anything. All this distraction that you are hearing on media will not affect you. You will be focused and be pursuing what you are supposed to pursue. That is why I have to play the message once again. One of the messages that he left that behind for us. Let us listen to Asorock leader MAZI NNAMDI KANU, what he had for us today. Let's hear from him.
I'm going to go to the top of the hill.
Message of Asorock MAZI NNAMDI KANU is food to me. It gives me strength, it shows me where to go, and it makes me to believe that Biafra is already here. Thank you so much for watching wherever you're watching from. May Chuku Kabia and protect Asorock MAZI NNAMDI KANU. May Chuku Kabia and guide and protect Asorock MAZI NNAMDI. May Chuku Kabia and bless him wherever he is. May Chuku Kabia and inspire him more and put word into his mouth to continue to send to us. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, guys, bye bye. See you again on the next video. Thank you.